presentation.
Hello everybody, this is last talk of the day. Some words about my motivation. Special collections often consist of very specific types of objects, some type or material fields, which may be selected from a list, or some things which are not part of the normal bibliographic data set. And this requires non-standard data structures. Often, this is supplemented by a custom navigation, for example, by a historical period or dynasty. And last not least, static pages, which are not directly part of the collection, but also important, like news or help pages, are required too. So turnkey standard systems for these requirements are often not available. And this leaves you with basically two options: to build a system custom tailored from scratch, or to adapt a general content management system or a framework to your requirements. I have gone through both of these. As a scientific software developer at ZBW, I'm mainly concerned with linked data and with knowledge organization systems and services. But some years ago, I published a 20th Century Press Archives, which consists of dossiers of some 100,000 of articles, newspaper articles. And I coded this in Perl as a custom-made web application. So when I now had the task to publish another set of data, these are projects from our ZBW Labs. It's a project information about beta application, about prototypes, and so on. I choose to try it with content management systems, namely Drupal. And I will talk about some of the experience in this process. I will first give a short introduction to linked data, to content management systems, and to Drupal, and will then show how Drupal 7 can be customized for semantic publishing of special collections. I will touch some current limitations of the linked data support there, I will end with an outlook to Drupal 8 and a brief summary. If you have a look at this web page, for humans it's clear at the first glance that's a page about a biography written by Haydn Hedera about the Mexican painter Frida Kahlo. For a machine, that's just guessing. Is the subject a book, a painting, a person? So the relations of two persons. So what you can do about it is to add some information in such a web page. By embedding semantic markup, you can unambiguously state that the subject of this web page is a book, and that the subject is of the book is one person, and it was written by another person. In RDF, the resource description framework, the subjects, predicates, and objects of these statements are expressed by your eyes, such as this, which links to WorldCat or references DBpedia, which is derived from Wikipedia, or we have as a virtual authority file. And if you can, if these URIs are resolvable over the web, over HTTP, which roughly means that you can look up them in a web browser to get more information, then you are already weaving the web of linked data and make your data set part of the well-known linked data cloud, ever enhancing since 2006 when Tim Berners-Lee introduced the idea. So linked data enhanced publishing allows you to differentiate the subjects of your web pages and the attributes, and thus foster data reuse in third-party services and applications. It allows other to work with your data in mashups, and especially allows search engines to understand it much more clearly, to build more expressive entries in their result lists, and perhaps even to rank your data higher. Last but not least, these are also meaningful links for your users to look up more information. Well, next question, why a content management system? Most important is that standard tasks like browser compatibility or page templates or CSS for responsive layouts and so on and so on are made easy. You can just build on well established patterns and tested code. It's easy to add Web 2.0 features like blocking or comments or tagging or something like this. And which is an important thing from a management point of view, know-how about this application is available outside a single development team. But the most important thing for us, why we choose especially Drupal, was that it has an open and modular architecture. It's extensible by thousands and thousands of contributed modules. It's based seriously on web standards. It's scalable up to very large sites, like the one of the White House or Amnesty International or the Louvre in Paris. It's widely used by hundreds of thousands of sites all over the world. And it is supported by a vibrant open source community and also by commercial services. So you can build also on this if you have some money to invest in this. Well, but the single point which for linked data publishing was specific for us was that Drupal supports a built-in RDF scheme. Do I have a pointer here? Yes. There's a note was the main content. Terms are marked up as cost concepts. Comments are marked up, users, and so on. So this is what you get for free. This made part of my job very easy because standard blog pages, the new section of this page was already marked up with, for example, as a title, as an author, as a created it as text, and this came out of the box. But we had this special collections, and we have some custom fields here, like a status of a project or the lifespan of the project, which may be different from the date of the web page, or for example, a home page or a code repository for some projects. And they have to mark up separately. And we need, basically, data structures to store this information. We can do this in Drupal by creating custom content types, which can be done by a simple web interface. You can add a type and a description and a lot of publishing options and settings for display and comments and so on. And you can define RDF types for such a new content type. In this case, we said this is a project according to the DOPE ontology. DOPE is a description of a project, an ontology on the web. And it's also creative work according to the schema.org ontology, which is used by the major search engines. The next step is to create the custom fields which are required. We have to add fields of a certain type, which are standard types like text or date or something like this. And you can create a widget, or you can select a widget for input of this data. For example, from a list or from a calendar pop-up. Especially interesting is this type of entity reference, which allows you to reference other, maybe custom or maybe built up content types within the system. So for example, for developers, we said, okay, these are users of the system. And just by definition, we can say, okay, and give me an autocomplete list of all users, and let me select one to make this connection within the standard CMS without any custom coding. We can add for these fields RDF mappings. And the nice thing is, as you may have observed also by at the content types, we can add different mappings from different ontologies, and it's just as easy as writing them down in a comma separate list. So we can use a specialized ontology like DOPE for somebody who wants to build a project, a repository software projects or search engine for this, but also something which is meaningful for Google or Bing. Drupal takes care of the output of these mappings, which are rendered in RDFA, which means that they are part of the HTML markup just on the page, and you don't have to care about HTML producing code or about trickling this into templates. This is already done by the Drupal RDF support. This is also true for different themes or screen layouts, which are in parts contributed to Drupal in a wide variety. Standard by default, it's RDFA 1.0, but it can also be HTML5 with RDFA 1.1. which is supported by some contributed themes. And what is produced by this is data like this, which you can extract from a RDFA page. This is shortened, but you see there are all the different vocabularies are referenced here. Well, this is a main capability in the field of linked Drupal. In the field of linked data, Drupal provides for you. However, there is more already. You can serialize RDF data in various formats. You can expose the embedded RDF data also in a Sparkle endpoint, which allows user to query it just like a SQL database. There is microdata support available as a possible alternative to RDFA. And on the other side, you can consume RDF data from other Sparkle endpoints to display it within the context of your site. Another possibility is to use a web taxonomy module to add links to other linked data entities, which is particularly interesting because it provides an autocomplete widget for Drupal fields, which can be powered by vocabularies which are maintained elsewhere. This has some prerequisites. You have, of course, you have to have for this vocabulary some auto-suggest web service, which can be queried. And you have to add custom code for this on how to query this web service, on which, what UI and what particular format the data is returned. We had done this, and you can use this as a plugin example, on taxonomies like the STW thesaurus for economics. And this gives you the option to use vocabularies for indexing without having to store a local copy and to update it and so on. But you can also take advantage, for example, you see we had input accounting, and you get a lookup of synonyms to find bookkeeping as a preferred term. These tools allows you to insert URIs for these terms or other entities, for example, from DBpedia. And by storing and exposing these URIs, you are making your website to part of the large linked data cloud. You can extend Drupal even further by because it's not only a CMS, it's a content management framework with well-defined APIs for database abstraction. You saw some user interface to the field and RDF mapping API already. And especially, you have an entity API which allows you to build custom entities with a almost completely arbitrary property structure, which may even reside on a remote database, which doesn't have to care about Drupal at all. This, however, requires substantial programming skills and is regarded out of scope of this talk. I will instead touch some limitations. Currently, you have to invest a bit of work to get cool URIs by standard, you get a query string like this, which is not nice. And it's easy to change this to URIs like this one, but it still has a serial number in it, which means that in each and every Drupal instance where you import this content, it will have another number, and thus no good URI. You can use a path module of which is also in Drupal core to define aliases for this URI, which makes a lot of sense. And it comes quite close. But if you have a multilingual instance, you still have a language identifier, and you want to publish normally some statements about a resource itself and not in a language independent way. So at this point, there was really custom code necessary to align this and get this URI. Another issue is that Drupal currently doesn't deal well with nested RDF structures. So, for example, we had in the dope ontology, the repository where the code resides is a separate entity, and we had to get this kind of data structure. We had to build a mapping a template file for this very field. To insert the extra level hard-coded. It was not nice, but it was doable, and it was, I think, one of 10 custom fields. So it still was worth the effort. Another limitation of which, depending on your data, may be hard, is that the RDFA support currently works for single entities, but not for aggregation of multiple entities, as you have some in search results or term pages of views, or to come back to the talk of Herbert this morning, to such ORE aggregations. I worked a lot with this in the Press Archives application, and this wouldn't be easily achievable currently with Drupal. And there are some issues under edge cases where RDFA output may break. Hopefully this will change in the next version of Drupal, Drupal 8, which is supposed to be ready end of this year or early next year. It has a large refactoring from base functionalities in Drupal, which was Drupal stems from 2004, and now it is ported to a very clean PHP framework with a lot which builds an object-oriented and modern foundation for it. One of the design goals of this refactoring is that web services should be much better supported in this architecture, so that applications, perhaps applications running on a phone, can get access to each piece of content within the Drupal data set. And this is a great advantage even for linked data publishing, of course, because all about linked data publishing is about URIs. The RDFF module itself will be split up in a back-end mapping part and in a RDFA part. So it hopefully will be also easier to add extended RDFA support. Well, to sum up, link data publishing via CMS, and in particular Drupal, isn't a valid option. If your data can be mapped to a essentially flat RDF data structure, linked data can be added mostly by site builders without much additional effort and requires no programming. Sometimes research is required on how to solve problems. And at times, you have to write glue code to achieve specific goals. But most of the code for your web application is already there, and it is supported by a very helpful and vibrant open source community. Thank you very much for listening, and I'm looking forward to questions.
Thank you, Neuber.